The camera obscura makes it possible to travel through time, to alter perceptions, and to challenge visual realities.
Then kind of back through that green loop there. Yeah.
This precursor to modern photography is a dark room in which light enters through a small hole or lens and projects an image of what is outside. The technology acts much like a giant pinhole camera. As a research assistant with the Camera Obscura project based at Thompson Rivers University, I participate alongside an international group of artists and other researchers who share an interest in this ancient optical technology and the broader links that it creates between art and science, learning, and play. For the last two summers, I've traveled to Dawson City, Yukon, where as a member of the research team led by Donald Lawrence, I worked with the Klondike Institute of Art and Culture to realize the 2015 Midnight Sun Camera Obscura Festival. We arrived mid-May for 1 month's artist residency in preparation for the festival, which took place over the summer solstice and held a series of artists' off-site projects, exhibitions, public workshops, and talks, which all focused on the camera obscura. I was able to learn a lot from working with this eclectic group of artists and researchers, who ranged from Dutch philosophers to Yukon locals. Together with the project team, we installed the camera obscura on the Yukon Ferry, as well as a large gold nugget camera obscura that made up Holly Warden Kevin Schmidt's Eye of the Beholder and Leah Bucknell's False Front. Research assistants were joined by TRU alumni to create another exhibition in response to the discourse and experiences that came as a result of the festival. We tend to view the camera obscura as a link to new technologies such as projectors and digital technology and how we connect them through history. As this happens to be a particular interest of Petran Kalkalkorn, one of the group's theorists, he offered us an opportunity to participate in a panel discussion during one of the festival events. The learning continues beyond the festival. Participating in the Camera Obscura project has brought additional focus to my artistic practice, in theoretical and practical ways, and has encouraged me to pursue a career in the visual arts. This January, I installed a new project at the Kamloops Art Gallery, which combined with the Dawson City exhibition provides a basis for further exhibitions across the country, as well as artists, residencies, and grad school. My name is Ryland Fortie, and this is my true research story.